Yeah, I trained at RADA. I went to RADA in the mid-70s, 1974 to 1976. And it was great, I had a great time. I guess I'd always wanted to be an actor. So it was a dream come true, really.
I'm assuming there's nothing getting into RADA in those days.
I was a fan early on. I used to watch the William Hartnells. I would have been about 8 when Doctor Who first went out, and I remember coming home one Saturday afternoon and my grandfather, who lived in the same house, saying, "Oh, you have got to stay in next Saturday and watch this. It's brilliant." Because he was a sci-fi fan, and it was great. I remember sort of the very first appearance of the Daleks, which I think was it in episode 3 or it wasn't in the first episode, was it? I think it was episode 3 or something. And I remember sort of just at the end of the episode, this plunger just came into shot, and I just remember thinking, just remember being absolutely terrified. But it was great. Oh, there goes
Davros.
Oh.
Bye. See ya.
Oh, yes, I went for an interview at White City. I saw Pennant Roberts, who was the director. It was a nice interview because he was Welsh, and I'm Welsh. So that probably helped. I'd done quite a lot of telly by then. And I'd always wanted to do a Doctor Who, I'd never done one, I'd never even been up for one before. And so that was great. And he apologised that it was only one episode, because they were 50-minute episodes at that time. And he said, because I got time lashed, because Ty here gets time lashed. But he said, if you like, you can have a voiceover and you can get an extra performance fee for doing the Bandril. So that's how I came to do the Bandril. So that was very kind of him. So I did Ty here and the Bandril. It was great. I remember we were very, very, very badly behaved. Actually, when we were making it, we laughed a lot. I remember we were all told off by Pennant quite a lot for having a generally good time while we were rehearsing. Because of course, in those days, you'd go into the North Acton rehearsal rooms, which we actors used to refer to as the Acton Hilton, and I think it was probably 8 or 10 days rehearsal, and then it was recorded over 2 or 3 days at White City in the studios. It was great. We had a really nice time. The cast were all very pleasant. We all got on very well. It was generally a very good time. Yeah. I remember Paul Darrow being very, very badly behaved. He's a very nice chap. What I do remember about recording it was that terrible wig that he wears in the show, which looks like Richard III. But we had a good time. I mean, I've done, probably about... Probably on my credits is probably something like 100 television appearances in various things, but actually, most of the people who contact me are fans of Doctor Who, and they usually send me photographs. So, actually, I think fans are more interested in me as the Bandril than they are as interested in me as Ty here. I kind of I get contacted quite a lot actually from fans of Doctor Who, which always surprises me, because it's such a long time now. But yeah, and I do know what how fans refer to Time Lash. I do know. I know the anagram. Well, I've still got an equity ticket. I still have a card. I've been writing for the last decade, really. I've written two horror thrillers. The first book is called Needham and Hart. The second book is called Wilhelm and Laszlo. They're the first and second part of a trilogy. And I've written a standalone psychological thriller called Road Rage. And yes, I mean, I'm kind of still open to acting, but I sort of don't have an agent anymore. It's a very difficult job to do, I think, once you sort of get to the point where other things are more important. You know, it's acting is one of those jobs where you've really got to be absolutely single-minded about it and totally committed to being an actor. And I don't think I've been totally committed to being an actor for quite a few years now. You know, and there are other things that are more important to me. And I guess that's... But I would sort of be happy to do some work, you know, and I'm moving back to Wales in the next... Well, probably in the next 6 or 8 weeks, I hope. If we can exchange contracts on the sale, and you know, I'm kind of hoping that, you know, maybe I'll do some work down there, actually, you know, because there's a lot of activity in Wales, you know, a lot of acting work down there now, and yeah, so maybe I'll do some work. Yeah, maybe I'll. Who knows? I might even do Doctor Who again. You know, that'd be nice. Yeah, because it's all filmed in Cardiff now. I don't know.